What was that moment like just at the end for you guys? Just seeing Devontae, of all people, with everything he's been through this year and everything that he's gone through, be able to hit that shot and give you guys this moment?
I don't know. I was very happy for Devontae. That's my brother, you know. He's a pro, stuck with it, you know, never complained, came in, played with the video guys all the time and, you know, stayed ready for this moment. So, to be honest, like, I would be happy for everybody, but, like, I'm very happy for Devontae because I feel like he deserves it and, you know, he's a great player.
You feel like that could be a good role model, a good lesson for some of the younger guys on this roster?
100%. You know, a lot of people are thinking now, you know, when, you know, you got to stay in the present, of course, but I feel like a lot of times, like, you're trying to rush the process and you can't. I feel like you got to just stay ready for your opportunity, but at the same time, come in every day and be a pro. And I feel like it's hard when you're young. You really don't understand it. But just being a pro, coming in here as a, like, building every day, I feel like it's going to get you to the time when your opportunity comes, you're going to be ready.
It feels like you do understand that, though.
Yeah.
And over the last couple of weeks, like, you've really been playing well. How do you feel like, what kind of impression do you feel like you've left with this team in front of the fans, all this other stuff over the last couple of weeks?
I hope I left a good impression. I would say I'm in an unbelievable spot. When I was young, I was dreaming of this position, so I never took nothing for granted. You know, I'm not the guy who holds grudges or anything or gets upset at home. Like, you know I'm in the best situation I can be. I'm, you know, I go home every day, see my dogs, and come in, and I have a big facility to work out in, and just the teammates, great teammates to be around, and great coach to learn from. So that's all I really want. And, you know, you just got to be a professional. You know, sometimes you won't play, sometimes you will, but one thing I know, every time I play, I'll execute, compete, and play with the heart. And, you know, no matter how many games I play, I will come in and be ready.
Pop just sat in the chair and said they have to have some serious discussions about bringing you back next year based on how you've played. What are your thoughts on that?
I don't know. You know, I don't really get into that situation. Like, I'm grateful for Pop for the opportunity. You know, he brought me in after I got waived from Milwaukee and believed in me from day one. I remember coming in, I was so nervous, and the first game he threw me in there, I had 6 points. I thought I was the man. I was walking around. I was like, I played NBA game and stuff like that. So, you know, I don't know what's going to happen in the future, but I love being here. I love being around the guys, connecting with them, learning, growing. So, you know, I'm looking forward to the future, and, you know, if it's here, I'll be very happy, but it's, you know, it's business, so we'll see what happens.
When you weren't playing, what was the explanation as to what you needed to work on or what was holding you back?
To be honest, you know, I feel like there was no explanation. I really didn't dig into it a lot. You know, as I said, I'm a pro. I just try to stay in my lane, have a tunnel vision. I knew somewhere my opportunity will come. So I feel like you find me out there asking a lot of questions, like I'm not focused on work. So I just stayed down, just worked, and just prayed that the opportunity would show itself. And it did. So, you know, it don't matter what happened in the past. As I said, I'm in the present. I'm very happy at this moment, very grateful, and, you know, looking forward to.
You feel like you're forming a pretty good connection with
the corner? Hell yeah. As I said, like, I've been with a lot of teammates, and I love them all, don't get me wrong. But when we went to New York and he came out to eat with me at the Georgian restaurant, and he loved the food, that's why I liked it. You know, a lot of people go eat the food and they be like, you know, but he really liked it. He devoured it. Like, you know, he told me he would go back. And, you know, I feel like we built a great chemistry outside, you know. So, to be honest, me personally, I'm very happy to play with him because, you know, I don't know if I'm gonna get that chance, but, you know, he's a special, special, special player. So just being out there and saying that I played with him and Giannis is two of the best players in the league. So I'm very excited.
When did it enter your head to pass that ball off that rebound as opposed to following it yourself?
I don't know, man. I feel like it's an instinct. You know, I try to play smart. I knew he's a tall guy. He can just put the ball in the basket. And, you know, Jokic looked at me, so I had a quick dime to him. So, you know, as I said, like, I love building chemistry with him. He's a great guy. And I feel like it was just the instant moment.
There was a moment during the game where Devontae pulled you off to the side. You know, midcourt. What was he telling you?
You talk
about his leadership.
Yeah, Devontae, as I said, he's a pro. You know, like a guy who stayed resilient, and he always, like, even when we were not playing, he was always telling the guys, like, yo, I feel like you should do this, or, you know, stay in the corner, don't cut too early, stuff like that. So I feel like he sees a lot of things, you know, a lot of young guys don't, because they're so excited to play. I don't remember exactly what he told me, because we have a lot of discussions. Some are serious, some are not. So, you know, I don't remember.
I'm curious, when B had that, got the tech, did that sort of motivate y'all or uplift you?
Hell yeah. You know what motivated me? When he fell on the floor and Gordon was looking at him. If I was on the court, I'd get a tech. I'm telling you right now. So I was happy I was sitting on the bench. I did not go in the court because that's $25,000. I don't have that. And so I just stayed back. But, you know, a lot of stuff, like when you see a heated game, they came back. We were down 23, I think, and we came back. And I feel like at that point, you don't want to let it up. You know, you just want to go full steam. And so happy we got the win.
I think that was the first tech that he'd had that wasn't like throwing the ball in the crowd or something like that. And he got like in Aaron's face. Like, is this stuff that Victor, that y'all see on the side from Victor?
He's a competitor. Yeah. Like, I feel like nobody can say nothing. The guy comes here, played, I don't know, 70 games his rookie year, and still wants to play against Detroit, and he doesn't care. Like, he wants to be out there. He wants to win. And, you know, a lot of guys just come in here and are so happy that they're in the NBA and they have this lifestyle and stuff like that. He doesn't care about that stuff. Every day's in the gym, stays late, comes early, takes care of his body. So, you know, I'm surprised how good he is and how professional he is. And, you know, I feel like even sky's not a limit. He's an alien, so, you know, you're going to see him.
So did you see his Nike ad? Was it good?
Yeah, hell yeah. Fire. I needed one pair of the and Wembys, so send it to me.
I think I should write his Nike ads. That was pretty
good.
Yeah,
it was good.
I think I should. You know, I think I should do a lot. I can't be his manager if he wants me to after I retire. So thank you so much, guys. Really appreciate all the support. Thank you.